In this rapidly evolving world of big data, you're often tasked with analyzing large data sets efficiently, and the good news is that you can now do this with minimal effort, without any infrastructure work, and using a leading open source data processing and analytics framework. In this video, we're going to show you how to make your Spark jobs run like a well-oiled machine in a serverless setup on the Google Cloud platform. In particular, we'll highlight the Dataproc service and demonstrate its setup and use in the Google Cloud console. If you're tuning in, you likely already have a good understanding of Spark. However, to summarize, Spark is all about large-scale data processing and analytics. With over 36,000 stars in its open source project, it's an excellent way to run your data pipelines and analytics. Combined with Google Cloud's fantastic serverless offering, it's like a match made in heaven. So, let's dive into the Google Cloud console and guide you through setting up this service and how to use it specifically for PySpark jobs. First, head to Dataproc, which will necessitate enabling an API if you're using a new project. With the service activated, we can use Dataproc for both serverless Spark and Spark on static compute clusters. We won't spend significant time discussing non-serverless options, but contrasting them with serverless choices is informative. For instance, we can create a cluster and explicitly specify node parameters while configuring many other aspects of the cluster. From turning on specific optional components to configuring a Dataproc Hive metastore, the customization possibilities are numerous. However, running this cluster incurs costs regardless of whether we're actively running Spark jobs. That's not a particularly cost-efficient approach, so we're going to focus on the newer serverless offering instead, where Google handles the infrastructure behind the scenes. Next, let's create a simple job to run across standard and serverless Spark options. We'll use the Google Cloud Shell IDE, but feel free to follow along in your preferred IDE. As usual, we'll share all the code in the description of this video. Our Spark job will involve rudimentary analysis of a CSV file, showcasing how Google's serverless and high-scale storage solution works in our Dataproc jobs. We'll store this in a Google Cloud storage bucket shortly. For our code, we'll draw on a basic PySpark demo script that will run on our serverless Spark system. We'll be retrieving the books.csv file from our bucket, then performing an elementary analysis of the data. Spark typically entails reading, transformations, and writing to another data source, but we'll keep things simple for now. Although you can use HDFS storage with your Spark clusters on Google Cloud, we highly recommend choosing Google Cloud Storage to capitalize on cost savings, performance improvements, and scalability gains. Now let's establish the Google Cloud Storage bucket that will support our Spark jobs. Keep in mind that bucket names must be unique worldwide. Default settings should otherwise suffice for our purposes. Next, we'll incorporate this bucket into our PySpark job configuration. Then, we'll download and store the PySpark script file and books.csv in our cloud storage bucket. Files prepped, we're ready to return to Dataproc and run our job. The execution method will be quite similar for serverless and standard clusters, though performance, cost, and scalability vary dramatically. For instance, submitting the job through the standard cluster interface involves selecting PySpark and specifying our Python file. Often, additional jar files are needed, which can be designed here or integrated into custom containers for clusters or serverless jobs, but we'll keep things simple for now. The serverless interface may look strikingly similar, but it only charges us for the compute power we actually use, and we don't need an ongoing cluster. To ensure your VPC and associated subnets have the required networking to enable serverless Spark jobs, go to the associated subnet, in this case we're using US Central 1, and simply turn on private Google access. We should then be able to run our serverless Spark jobs either in the console or via the command line interface. Since the interface is nearly identical to the standard Dataproc cluster case, we'll launch one from the CLI. Now we have a successful serverless Spark job run. We hope this has been a helpful quick introduction, and we'll keep an eye on the comment section for any questions. Thank you for watching, and please enjoy responsibly.